Hello everyone, this is Snigdha Mahapatra and today I will be talking about the concept and validity of wills under Indian law. A will is a legal document that sets forth your wishes regarding the distribution of your property and the care of any minor children. If you die without a will, those wishes may not be carried out. In other words, your will is the formal document that sets out what is to happen to your property and assets when you die. It is a legal document that is officially binding on your executors, which means that they don't have any choice whether or not to follow it. Section 2, subsection H of the Indian Succession Act 1925 provides that will means the legal declaration of the intention of a person with respect to his property which he desires to take effect after his death. A will has been defined as the legal document of a man's intention which will be performed after his death, or an instrument by which a person makes disposition of his property to take effect after his death. Section 63 of the Indian Succession Act 1925 describes a condition for a valid will, those being: the testator should sign or attach his imprint, for example thumb mark or signature. The will must bore witness by at least two observers. The witness must have seen the testator sign or append his imprint to the will. Each witness will sign the will within the sight of the testator. Who can make a will? According to Section 59 of the Indian Succession Act, the person making a will must be of sound mind. Besides, it has been expressed that an individual, usually of the unsound psyche, may make a will during the time span of the soundness of his or mind. The segment denies an individual from making a will when in a condition of inebriation or illness, which makes him or her inequipped for understanding the results of the act. There are basically two types of will under the Indian Succession Act, that is privileged will and unprivileged will. What is a privileged will? Indian Succession Act 1925 gives certain benefits to a soldier, a pilot, and a sailor adrift utilized in an undertaking or engaged in actual warfare. These benefits are ordered remembering the problems of a soldier during his residency or during his administration. Arrangements relating to such benefits are referred under Section 66, Subsection 2 of the Indian Succession Act 1925. Such wills are called privileged wills. Unprivileged wills. Wills created by a testator not being a soldier is known as unprivileged wills. These wills are generally created by the masses. Unprivileged wills are governed under Section 63, Subsection 5 of the Indian Succession Act. What should be included in a will? In a will, the following details are to be included. First, details of the testator, that is the name, age, address, which will help in recognizing who is making the will and when it is being drawn. Second, declaration. Significantly, the testator proclaims that he/she is of sound brain and liberated from any pressure while drawing the will. Third, the executor of the will. The details of who will profit out of his will and to whom shall the assets be divided should be given as their name, age, address, and connection to the testator. Fourth, details of the beneficiary. It is essential to appoint an agent who might guarantee that the will is done by the testator. The name, age, address, and connection to the testator should be specified as well. Fifth, details of property and assets. It is relevant to mention all the details of the assets and properties that a testator has and which are the ones that will be canvassed in the will. He/she can likewise drill down a particular resource that is there. Sixth, division of shares. The offer that every recipient has on the property are the points of interest who will persuade what is to be recorded in full detail. On the off chance that the advantage is to be given to a minor, at that point a caretaker for the minor ought to be likewise recorded in the will. Seventh, specific directions. The testator should give headings as far as executing the will and should be determined if there are any guidelines. Eighth, witnesses. There should be a mark by the testator within the presence of any event, two observers. The observers don't have to know the detail of the will. They simply need to check that the mark by the testator was done before them. Signature. The testator should assign with the date on the will after the last explanation. Execution of a will. For beginning the procedure of execution of a will, a probate in India should be obtained from the court. A probate of will is a legitimate confirmation of the validity of the will. It tends to be acquired by documenting an appeal under the watchful eye of the court alongside a calendar of the property and adding a duplicate of the will to the request also. It ought to be explicitly appealed to the court to concede probate to complete the aim of the testator. That is all for now. Thank you and see you in another video.